Hey, University of Tampa, John Belinsky here. I'm really excited to be able to come in the first week of January and spend 3 hours teaching you EKG. I mean, you guys know EKG, but it's the transition from academics to clinical. My whole goal is to give you real tools so EKGs aren't intimidating, but I get it. To some of them, it's elusive. I mean, you're looking at a line, a squiggly line, and it's giving me information whether the person's going to live or die or what interventions I have to do. So on rotations, this is one of those things you can really look good or like an idiot. Okay, hey, what do you see here? If you don't have something intelligent to say, your preceptor is going to go, it's one of those. So my goal is to really bring you up a level into how you see the lines, how you treat the lines. But here's something that I need to insist upon. You know, I'm going to come in and share this information with you, but I need you to do some work before we get in there. So this video is going to have some mnemonics and key understandings that you have to prepare for before I walk in. And I'm going to promise you something. To serve you, I'm going to hold you accountable on this content. So as soon as I come in, I'm going to pimp you. I'm going to pimp you guys to make sure that you really have mastery of this, because I can't teach EKGs without foundations. Okay, so please watch this video. Know this before you walk in. Don't try to cram it in the last day. You'll thank me for it. Like if you're going to get into orthopedics, okay, well, you don't need EKGs. If you're going to get dermatology, you don't need EKGs. Primary care, internal medicine, hospitals, cardiology, emergency medicine, critical care, cardiothoracic. You know, there's lots of fields that do need to know this. Now, you'll need to know it for rotations and you need to know it for your boards. And EKGs are cool. So please study this video coming up, master it. And if you YouTube me, I have a bunch of different, you know, videos on this on YouTube, and I have a podcast called Talk EM. You can also find a bunch of information there. And I really look forward to working with your college. We had a wonderful board view course this year, and I look forward to being a small part of your success. I love being a PA, guys. It's worth it. Okay, guys, here are the key principles that I need you to know before I walk in January to help you really have a really good understanding of EKGs. Now, because I deeply care about you guys knowing your stuff, I'm going to promise you, I'm going to be merciless about this in the first 15, 20 minutes to truly make sure you know this well. If you don't know this, if you come in sketchy, I will identify you, okay? And I'm doing this because I know how important this is. I've taught this for a long time. So please, colleagues, study this, master it, because it's going to help you to really help take care of patients at a high level. And it's going to make you look good. So there's so many win-wins on this. So please take a time period that's disciplined and master this content. So here's the first thing I want you to know. If you take your left hand right now, take your left hand and put it towards your face. So you're looking at your left hand. Now take a pen and on your hypothenar eminence, write the AV node, or put it just a dot on your hand. That dot represents your AV node. Then your pinky is going to represent your right coronary artery. It's on the right side of your hand. That's your RCA. And that leads to 3AVF, also known as your inferior wall. You have to know that. Now, the webbing of your hand is your left main coronary artery. Think of this. Your left side of your heart is so big, you need two primary vessels. So you have your circumflex artery and your LAD. Circumflex is 1AVL, V5, and V6, and your LAD is V1 through V4. So here's what I'm going to challenge you to do. And just so you guys know, if you do this, if you do what I'm going to say right now, you and I will be kindred spirits, because it says you're one of those people that you want to have mastery of content. You're not comfortable just being familiar. Take a Sharpie marker and write on your hand. So for your pinky, write RCA, inferior wall, 2-3-AVF. Your thumb, circumflex, lateral wall, 1AVL, and then V5 and V6. And then your pointer finger, that's your LAD, it's your anterior wall, V1 through V4. You have to have mastery of that. Okay, now, if you notice the RCA artery, the right coronary artery, it is right by the AV node. So the right coronary artery feeds your AV node. Why is that important? Because whenever someone has an inferior wall MI, an inferior wall STEMI, or inferior wall ischemia, they're classically bradycardic because that AV node does not get perfused. It's classic. So here's a different way to see it, where your lateral wall is 1AVL, V5, V6, circumflex. Your inferior leads are 2-3AVF, that's your RCA. And your anterior wall is V1 through V4, that's your left anterior descending. You have to have mastery of this. Like, I can't waste time teaching you this. This is just rote memorization. And you got to do the work before I walk in. So if you look at the blue writing or the blue circles, blue, it's your lateral wall. So it's one ABL, and V5 and V6. Ladies and gentlemen, those shapes in front of you are the contiguous leads. Like, if that term has been elusive to you, I get it, but one and ABL, they're contiguous because they're fed by the same artery. V5 and V6 are contiguous. 2-3 AVF, that's inferior leads fed by your right coronary artery, they're contiguous. V1 through V4, that's your anterior leads fed by your LAD, and those are contiguous. So you have to know that before I walk in. Now, there are four mnemonics that you have to know. I will explain these mnemonics to you. I'll explain them and then show you clinical applications. So here's what I'd like you to think about. This is a linking tool. Close your eyes for a second. Close your eyes and just listen to me. Picture a person holding up an apple. Just picture an apple being held by a hand. Another person comes up with a drill, a portable power drill, and drills a bunch of holes in the apple. So it goes apple, drill. Now those peels fall on the floor. Some other guy comes walking by. He doesn't see the peels. He slips. He falls down. He hits his head. And then he has to go to a CVS pharmacy because he hurt his head. So here's the four things I want you to remember. Apple, drill, slip, CVS. Now, just so you know, if you closed your eyes and did that exercise with me, you and I would be kindred spirits because you're really someone who really wants to learn deeply. Okay, if you didn't close your eyes, go back, re-watch this video, re-listen, and do the exercise. Trust me. So here's what I need you to know. There's five causes of ST segment elevation. The mnemonic is APPLE. It's acute MI, also known as a STEMI, Prinz metal, pericarditis, left ventricular aneurysm, and early repolarization. Now, guys, if you don't know exactly what those mean, I don't really care about that right now. You'll know by the time you're done with my three-hour session. But for right now, I just need you to have a mastery of those mnemonics. DRIL, D-R-I-L, it's digoxin, reciprocal changes, ischemia, and left ventricular strain. So if I said to you, what are the four causes of ST segment depression? You say digoxin, reciprocal changes, ischemia, and strain. And I'll tell you what, someone on rotation is going to ask you that question. And if you have that dialed in, you're going to look good. So it goes... Apple, drill, slip. Slip is if there's T-wave inversions. Stroke, left ventricular strain, ischemia, and pulmonary embolism. And then CVS pharmacy. These are the causes of a wide complex QRS of greater than 3 small boxes or greater than 0.12. CVS, it's a conduction problem, a ventricular rhythm, or systemic problem. So what are the conduction problems that will give you wide complex QRS? WPW, bundle branch blocker, pacemaker. It could be a ventricular rhythm, whether it's VTAC or PVC, or it could be a systemic problem. The most common is hyperkalemia. It could be digoxin or a tricyclic overdose. All right, folks, you have your assignment. I look forward to working with you guys and making this next year extraordinary. Let's start it out in a really great way. I'll see you soon.